Playing Ohio State, I watched every snap. You were, you know, gloriously talented guy, right? And then I see this play right here. And I watch this, Baker, and you throw a touchdown. And instead of, and I don't like this. I'm going to tell you right now. How come you're not, what? Where are you going? Where are you going over there?
Our band is over there. Our student section's right there. And then straight back to our sideline.
What about your team?
Did you watch the rest of the game?
I watched the whole game.
You did? So you saw me celebrate with my teammates like the three touchdowns before that, too?
I don't like that.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You pulled the one clip of me running right there to our fans and people that traveled well to that game, first of all. And then you didn't show the rest of the clip of me going to our sideline?
No, no, no. Have to go to the sideline. You're not going to go to the hospital. Well, where are you going to go after the touchdown? You're not going to go.
Well, you're acting like I just ran away from everybody.
Well, you did, but then you came back and circled to the sideline.
This is a 5-second clip of your showing me, and then I'm off the screen right there?
I'd like you to be with your teammates.
Watch the rest of the game, I was.
All right. Oh, I know you went back to the sideline.
No. Go watch the other touchdowns. I got very excited on that one.
So you think my accusation that this isn't
the fact, I feel like you're going for the fact that I'm not a team guy. I'm selfish. Is that what you're shooting at right here, or what?
No, I don't think that. I think sometimes your judgment's just a tad off, and I think the NFL's a judgment league because the game is so fast. Mm-hmm. You have to make the windows get really, really tight and really, really small. You got to make decisions really, really fast. In college, you got that Orlando Brown guy. You got a little more time. I don't love that decision. I don't love it.
The celebration? Do you see what people do in the league now, celebration-wise?
Hip thrusting, not a fan. Not a big fan of hip thrusting. I'm not going to lie to you. I don't like when Antonio Brown's doing that stuff. I'm not into it. You know what? Well, do you have your celebration?
No, I have nothing. I have nothing.
You're just going to give the ball to
Apparently, I think I need to just run away.
Okay. All right. We got to get to the other one. The other guy showed it too. I don't think I'm being a jerk.
What is it?
I have a general rule. Don't like my quarterback showing up on police video. Don't love this.
That's what you said I was undraftable for. So let's watch it.
That's why I don't like this. This doesn't do it for me. So what are you doing?
I was not in trouble. Then the state of mind that I was in, which shouldn't have happened. They started asking me questions. I watched somebody get just absolutely socked right in the face. Okay. And so I was answering questions.
So you were in an area where something bad happened.
Yeah, yeah. Was never directly in trouble, but then when they were asking me questions, for some reason, I thought I was in trouble. And decided to try. I wouldn't say it's a runaway, because that's not real good speed right there. But
when you look at that now, are you embarrassed? Are you mad?
Absolutely. There is so much regret about that, because if I didn't run, there would have been
nobody cares.
No, ever. You wouldn't have said that I was undraftable, and then nobody would probably have been questioning me about being the next dropout of football. So, no, there's a lot of regret to it, but at the same time, that was a rude awakening to responsibility and accountability for me. That a lesson that was harshly learned. Yeah, I could have learned it over time, but that was just very eye-opening for me.
By the way, that's the best answer you've given me in 10 minutes, by far. Embarrassed, learned a lot. That's what I want to hear. I'm a general manager. That's the best 30 seconds in your interview right there. That's what grown-ups say.
Hey, I appreciate that.
That makes me like you more. That's like, okay. If you
Now we're moving somewhere.
You and I are not moving anywhere.
Oh,
you're going to go be a starting quarterback, and I'm going to be a radio idiot. Okay, we've got our own lives. Okay, so now let's do good stuff. Let's move into the good stuff I like. You're accurate. You throw a really good football. You have no chance to bust as long as you get a little protection. Give me a little backstory on this. I am surprised you had to walk on. You throw an incredibly accurate football, and it's why you're going to win a lot of games in this league. I don't think you're Drew Brees. I think that's unfair and ridiculous. Have you always been – were you a baseball player? Why are you so accurate? Because it is your strength, and it's real.
I was a baseball player, but I wasn't a pitcher. I'm definitely way more accurate with the football than I am a baseball.
Okay.
I had to learn how to be accurate with it because of how big I was growing up. I wasn't the biggest guy, but what got me by was the mental aspect of the game and then also just putting the ball in the right spot. There's a saying that you can't defend a perfect ball. I don't care who you are. You can't defend a perfect ball.
Okay. Here's the second thing I like about your game is that – a lot of the truth of pro football, I mean, it's violent. And it's like college football players are good. NFL players are superhuman.
Everybody's good.
And I just watched The Incredibles with my son yesterday. Like, it's like superhero stuff, right? You always keep your eyes down the field. And by the way, a lot of guys don't. They can hear footsteps. You are all dialed in here. tell me, you've never been the biggest quarterback, the biggest guy. How are you able to stay totally focused on the action when you have guys who bench press Oklahoma breathing and bearing down on you? Because this is one of your – I talked to a GM about this. I said the one thing I love about him, he's accurate, and that kid did not hear footsteps. Where's that come from?
I don't know. I think I just kind of trained myself to always find the best option. And sometimes when you have a lot of chaos in the pocket, there's somebody screaming open down the field. And so just knowing that I can take a hit, if it's worth it to get the ball out of my hands and in somebody else's, I'd take that chance. But nowadays it's a little bit faster. And so the time clock in my head needs to speed up.
By the way, you can sense it's faster even at camp.
Oh, absolutely. You can sense the fact that I need to be able to go through 1, 2, maybe 3, and then it's either throw the ball away, or if there's a lane to step up and run, actually tuck it and run, you need to do that and then get down and protect yourself.
10 seconds. Were you a good student at Oklahoma?
Football was my favorite.
Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah.
By the way, I was a C+ guy. Yeah. You know, I knew what I wanted to be.
My parents would not be very happy about that one, but I did graduate.
All right. I mean, look at this thing here. You got a big support group. I'm out here by myself. I got all these people that hate me off to the side. I think you did.
Well,
really
they heard
good.
What you were saying. They thought they needed to come support me. Okay. I appreciate it, guys.
I thought you did a nice job. I appreciate you coming.
Thank you.
I totally appreciate you coming. You answered every question. And I really like what you said about the police video. I thought you sounded like a real grown-up. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
I mean that. Good luck to you, Baker.
Appreciate that.
Hour 2 next. The FIFA World Cup continues. Yes.